Hello everyone, and again welcome to Daily Tuition. In the previous video, we created a login page design with ASP.NET. But in this video, we are creating a database with some value to validate our user. So before we getting late, let's get started. In the Visual Studio, right click on your project. Go to Add and Insert SQL Database. And here, specify your database name and click on OK. And again, click on Yes to create this file in a app data folder. It takes some time. After your database file is successfully created, double click on your database file. And here, right click on your table and select New Query. Now, we wanted to create a table for our login page. Now, type the command create table login. Login is your table name. Double parenthesis and semicolon. Now, we are creating a three columns. ID, uname and passwd. So, type ID, integer, primary key and identity. We will increase our identity value to 1 and start our identity value from 1. Type uname varchar 50. Type passwd varchar 50. And we want to execute this command. So select this command and click on execute button. Here you will see command is successfully completed. So now we want to insert some values to validate our user. So type insert into login. Login is our table name. So in the bracket, we want to specify our parameter. So we specify our uname and password, values, and the parameter insert your value. I am taking AK, comma, KA. AK is my username and KA is my password. After you create this command, select this command and click on execute. We are only change these values. And again, click on execute. Make sure the command which you want to execute is selected. Select star from login. Select this command and click on execute. So our value is successfully inserted in our database. So back to your login page. Before we move forward, we wanted to create an event on our social link. So here we are creating an event. When a user clicks on the social link, the user will redirect to their profile. So create an anchor tag. And in href, specify your Facebook account. In the second image, we are specifying our Google Plus account. Make sure your profile image is between anchor tag. If your image is after the closing anchor tag, then this will not work. So be careful about it. So we will do the same to our another image. Run our project. So when we click on Facebook, you are redirected to your Facebook account, and when you click on your Google Plus account, then this is our Google Plus account. So now we want to move forward with our database. So from the data, select SQL data source and drag and drop this SQL data source in our login page and go to your design bottom of the screen. From here, we want to click on this icon and click on configure data. And here we want to specify our database and click on next. Again, click on next, but make sure you do not want to uncheck this box and click on next. Test your query, then click on finished. Now we want to create an event on a submit button. So type onClick equal to create a new event. It will automatically create an event on your source code. So right click and go to view code. So here we are creating our connection. So first we want to insert some namespace. So type using system.data. Another namespace is system.data.sqlclient. This namespace is used to access the SQL. This namespace is used to access the SQL classes in your project. So make sure you are inserted this namespace. And the last, type system.configuration. With using of this namespace, we are creating a connection. SQL connection con is equal to new SQL connection. In the bracket, type configuration manager dot connection string and copy your connection string from the login.aspx page. Make sure this connection string is correct. And dot, type dot and the last connection string and close this statement with semicolon. Open your connection and type SQL command cmd is equal to new SQL command. Type your SQL query, which is select star from login. Login is your table name, where uname is equal to @username. @username is our value, and passwd is equal to @password. So we are specify the value for this field. Type comma and connection string. And close this statement again. After you complete this, type cmd.parameter.addWithValue, and we want to specify our values to this parameter. So type @username and our text box name. In the second parameter, we want to specify a text box 1. So type textbox1.text. In the next line, type again cmd.parameter.addWithValue and specify the second text box. So now we assign the value to this fields. So when the SQL statement is executed, our value is accessed from text box 1 and text box 2. Type SQL data reader SDR is equal to CMD, means our SQL command dot execute reader. Execute reader is read our data from the data source. Close this statement. Go to your next line and type if. We are using the read method to obtain a row from the data reader object. After you create this if statement, back to your login page and drag and drop your label element. This element is used to show up our errors. So we are creating some style to this error. So style is equal to padding left 4 vertical width and padding top is equal to 2 vertical width, and the font size is equal to medium, and we are taking a for color red. So that's all. Go to your view code and type your label 1.text. Make sure your label ID is correct. Type label 1.text is equal to your message. So we are creating a login successful message. Next, we want to create a else statement. So type else, curly brackets and enter. In the else statement, we are creating an error message for those users who enter wrong username or wrong password. Close our connection. Make sure that your connection was closed. Right click on login page and select view in browser. So now we will see our project is properly run or not. So type your username and password in the text box and click on submit. So you will see your login is successful. But if someone want to redirect their user to another page, then right click on your project and select add webform and create your home page. We are using this web page only for sample, so we are only add h1 tag in this webform and type welcome to home page. Back to your login page and here type response.redirect and absolute path of your homepage.aspx page. So when your username and password is correct, you will redirect to your homepage directly. But now we wanted to hide our password field. So in the text box to type text mode is equal to password. Go to your style.css file and copy this input class and paste this here and rename text to password. So if you want to apply this style to your password field, this is necessary. So now run your project. You will see our password field is actually look like a password. That's all. If you find something useful in this video, then click on like button and also click on the subscribe button to encourage me to create an advanced video in programming. So that's all for today. See you in the next video. Till then, be happy and keep watching.